I am Nitesh Pradhan from LabVIEW and Multisim. In this video, we will learn how can we generate sound using the different kind of frequency. So here, I am going to show you the example first. After that, we will design. So first, run the program. Now I am changing the frequency. And you will find the sound. So let's see how can we write this program. So to write the program, press Ctrl N and Ctrl T. Now come into the block diagram. Come here. You will get this sound and graphics. In this sound and graphics, you will get this sound. Here three options are present: output, input and files. So come into the outputs, take a configuration windows. Configuration functions, then take this write functions, then take this clear functions. After that, rename all this. In this sound output configure, there is a sound format. So right click and create constant. So it is a sound format constant. In this constant, you can see it is a cluster type. So in this cluster type, you can see these are two different kind of data types. Okay. So first rename this cluster. Now come into the cluster and break. To break the cluster, we can use this bundle by name functions, unbundle by name functions. So now you can see we can use these functions. Now we have one divide functions. Why we will use? I will tell you. Using the divide functions, okay, whatever the sampling rate is present here, okay, sample rate per second is present, I will divide that value with the 4, and after that whatever the value will come out, I will put in the number of sample here, okay, number of sample per channel. Okay, now these are the number of sample, how many samples. So whatever the sample sample is present here, you can change it as per your requirement. Okay, so now it's complete. Now there is sample mode. So there are two kind of sample, that is clear. So one will be the finite sample and one will be the continuous sample or infinite sample. So let's see what kind of sample is present. Okay, so continuous sample is present. Now this one is stable completely. So here I am going to connect this one. And I am going to connect this one. Now here, right click, come here and take a while loop. Make a connection like this. Make a connection like this. Refnum in and out. Okay. After that, we need one After that, we need one tone generator. We need one tone generator. Using that tone generator, we can create the sound. Okay. We can create the voice. We can create the sound. So for the tone generator, we can use one sine wave generator. So for that, we can come into the sine signal processing and the signal generation. In the signal generation, first column, first, second, third, and fourth condition, the sine wave are present. So we can take the sine wave, not sine pattern. So this is a sine wave. Output of the sine wave will be go to the input of this. So it will be a sine wave. Now let's connect. Okay. So here, these are the number of Let's see, here I am going to show you something. Press Ctrl H. When you will click the sign, so the first one is sample. Okay, so first one is the samples. So I am providing the sample using these connections. So now after that, we need third one is the frequency. Fourth one is first, second, third frequency. So for the frequency here, we can use one concept, and concept will be I can use this divide concepts. I can connect with the frequency, and in this divide concept, okay, this line, are you able to see? So I can use this line, okay, for the frequency. So let's see, can we connect it? Yes, definitely we can connect. So now let's try to set the frequency. So for the frequency here, I am creating the control, okay, it will be a frequency. This control will be a frequency. Okay, so now the program is ready to run. So before that, I am going to create a control. Using this control, we can control the program. So now I think each and everything is set, because I have given one tone here. So to display what kind of signal I am generating, okay, to display the signal here, now you can see in the front panel, I have one frequency and a stop button. So I will put the stop button in the top, and then after I will right click in the frequency, I will come into the replace, and in the replace we'll get the numeric in the first and the first column second orienter slider bar. I will select this orienter slider bar. Okay, let's increase the orienter slider bar size here like this, and here 1000. Okay, we can increase it later more. So here I will use one waveform graph. In this waveform graph, I want to display that sine wave. Okay, I want to display that sine wave and the frequency concept. Okay, so when we will increase the frequency, it will display the sine wave as per the frequency. And you can also examine how the frequency, how the tone is increasing, okay, as per the our given frequencies. So you can see both things here. So now here I can take one more sine wave form. So for the histogram display, so let's come into the block diagram. So there are two sine wave form. So where it is, it is a waveform graph, second one is here, and one waveform graph I am using to display the signal, basic signal, whatever we are generating, I want to use. Okay, so now here right click, come into the express. We can take histogram functions from other platform, but let's see, can we we'll find any histogram here in signal processing. Let's check it fast. Okay, don't waste time and come into the express signal processing histogram. So take this histogram and place here. Okay, number up and maximum minimum. So let's see here. Okay, now you will see one thing. I'm going to set it back, take it back more. Now when I will connect this sine waveform with here, so automatically one conversion will be occurred, that will be from DTT, okay, to DTT, to dynamic data type. Okay, array to dynamic data type, it will convert our array to, it is an array concept, so it will convert that array to dynamic data type. Now our program is run, ready to run. Let's come into the front panel and run. So now you can see it is histogram. Here I am going to, Okay. So it is our code, and you can write the, sorry, you can generate your the tone as per the your given. You can generate the sound as per your given tone. So here, if you will use multi-tone signal, multi-tone waveform, or the multi-tone signal, so definitely it will give you the different kind of the data. Okay. So in the next video, if possible, so I will show you how can you generate a different how can you generate a multi-tone signal sound. Okay. So thank you for watching this video. Please try if you will like. So again. Try and if you like, so comment anything. If you like, then comment, or dislike, then comment. So thank you for watching this video.